Hi, and welcome back. I'm going to be now continuing on with that concept that we talked about in a previous video, gaslighting. So this is on how to spot when you're being gaslighted. And I hope you've had a chance to watch the first video in the series on gaslighting, on what is gaslighting. But just to recap what gaslighting is, it's a behavior in which a person manipulates another. It can be done consciously by the gaslighter, and sometimes at an unconscious level also. The behavior of gaslighting leads to the victim often questioning their own reality, and not the motives and the actions of the person gaslighting them. It can cause immense psychological and emotional pain and suffering. It usually occurs on a spectrum, and anyone can become a victim to it, and I mean anyone. It can occur in any form of relationship, from a parent-child relationship, between siblings, in a romantic relationship, marriages, at work, with an employer, or another colleague. On a larger scale, it can occur with social or religious leaders and the followers and heads of governments and their constituents, the population, us. Gaslighting is often displayed in a slow and gradual process. And the reason for this is that the victim does not catch on to what is occurring. The victim often dismisses isolated acts of gaslighting through using manipulation as they occur intermittently over long periods. If the gaslighting behaviors were to happen in a shorter period, the victim might make the connection much quicker. Today we're going to move on to how to spot the signs of someone gaslighting you. It can be challenging to ascertain if someone is gaslighting you. As we spoke about in the first video, there's often a power imbalance in the relationship to begin with. For example, a parent and an adult child, an employer and an employee, or just the fact that within a friendship or relationship, one person has the upper hand. The best chance you have of identifying this behavior is at its earliest stages, before the reality distortion and both psychological and emotional abuse have fully kicked in. Often the person may not wish to accept that gaslighting is occurring or think it's just a normal part of the relationship. However, there are some specific signs you can look out for in your relationship to spot gaslighting as early as possible. It's also essential that you don't see all forms of negative behavior or interactions in a relationship is gaslighting. There is, of course, a myriad of other manipulative and negative behaviors people can use in relationships, such as pure manipulation, narcissism, obsessive behavior, and just general bad behavior. The most prominent sign of gaslighting is someone attempting to make you question your reality and decisions, leading to you questioning your own sanity. So what are some of the other signs to look out for in gaslighting? Of course, it depends on the type of relationship you're in and the intensity of the signs and the symptoms experienced, which we discuss shortly. For today, we're going to focus more on a romantic relationship. It's also essential that the signs can be shared, and we may be the perpetrator of them from time to time, and they are not gaslighting. That is, we might be ourselves be gaslighting. So what are the signs of gaslighting? The first one is feeling confused by the conversation and unable to follow it. You might feel foggy in a sense that this just, like, it's not making any sense. Often the conversation will change topic rapidly, or you just can't follow the other person's train of thoughts. It can be helpful to ask for a break or time out to collect your thoughts and try to piece together what was happening in the conversation. The second sign or symptom is doubting yourself. Now, this is a crucial sign to look out for. You might find yourself thinking, well, maybe I got that wrong, or maybe I think I heard them say that, well, maybe they didn't. When you find yourself doubting your perceptions regularly when interacting with a particular person, you might want to check if they're gaslighting you. The third sign and symptom is this over-the-top response to ordinary events. If you find that when you bring up relatively trivial matters, they respond in an over-the-top manner, such as you ask your partner why the bins weren't taken out, they respond with, "Why are you always complaining about me? What's wrong with you? This is your issue." The fourth sign or symptom is the conversation, look, it just goes around and around. If you find the discussion, it seems to have an endless loop, never concluding. Perhaps you're struggling to find the meaning in the conversation as it keeps looping around and around. The fifth sign and symptom is a change of topic or focus. Perhaps you bring up a topic or issue to discuss and they quickly change the subject. You might start to speak with your partner about your joint decision to go on a date night once a week, and they say, "I think we have more important things to talk about than that right now. What about what happened last night when we were watching TV? Why do you focus on the little things all the time?" And the sixth sign or symptom is that if you feel like you're walking on eggshells around the other person much of the time, perhaps you find yourself stressing before bringing up anything with them and concerned about their strong reactions displayed. The seventh sign or symptom is the spoken words and behaviors are, look, they're just not matching. Maybe your partner says that they love you, but act in a hurtful way. Or you may experience your partner as charming and thoughtful, and then find they're doing unkind things behind your back. You will usually end up feeling uncertain and confused much of the time. The gaslighter might use the following strategies in conversations with you. The first one is countering, often questioning the validity of what you're saying or what you recall. So they're almost questioning that, look, what you're saying doesn't make sense. It's not based on any evidence. Another one is blocking or diverting. They may quickly and frequently change the subject and question your perception of events or thoughts. They may refuse to listen to you or put up barriers to listening. Another one is trivializing. They may try to make your needs or feelings seem inconsequential or small and insignificant. Another strategy is what's called forgetting or denial. They will frequently claim they have forgotten what occurred in the past or deny something previously stated or agreed upon. Now, in terms of the effect of gaslighting behavior on yourself, you might start to notice the following. The first one is that, look, you don't trust your decisions, so you're almost like questioning yourself constantly. Secondly, you have this feeling that something is wrong or off in the relationship, but you just can't put your finger on what it is. And the third one is that you find yourself apologizing more and more for things that, look, you don't understand. So it's almost like this empty apology, because I don't know what I'm apologizing for. The fourth one is you have this sense of confusion or feeling lost much of the time in regard to the relationship. The fifth is that you're starting to question yourself. Like, am I too sensitive? Am I too needy? Maybe it's me. All these questions revolve around your sense of reality, your feelings, and your instincts. When you feel you're having difficulty trusting your mind and intuition, this is a sign you may be being gaslighted. Now, thanks very much for watching this next video in the series on gaslighting. And I do hope that it's been useful and you've gained something from it and become much more aware of when you are being gaslighted on. but also sometimes you yourself might be the perpetrator. Now, thanks very much for watching, and please comment, subscribe to the Mind Life Flow channel, and also make sure to push the notifications bell so that you know when I release other videos, if you like watching them. Thanks again. Bye for now.